Welcome, my name is Jack Cooper. I'm going to tell you a true story of a congressman who broke all the rules of honesty and moral ethics. A man who enters into office not to improve the life of his constituents, but for himself. He used the power of his office, the type of power he wanted, to accumulate knowledge of corruption and to gather dirt on as many politicians, city, county, and federal officials as possible. As a congressman, he had unfettered access to sensitive information. He used this information to control and coerce almost anyone. In the political world, they call it leverage. The real meaning in this case is blackmail. His intention was to create a high-level criminal syndicate within the 11th Congressional District of Northern California to operate on both sides of the law, reputation of being the 13th most corrupt congressman in the country. A congressman who wanted to be crime boss. You may have already figured it out. It's Richard Pombo, former congressman. Each episode will show video of true corruption, conspiracy, violence, intimidation, with a hidden video camera proving extortion firsthand. Secrets of true corruption and conspiracy in ways you never expect. I go public not just to whistleblow. It has gone way too far for that. As dangerous as it was on December 1st last year, it is my responsibility to protect my family's safety and survival. Close calls are no longer a coincidence. They are becoming more frequent and just as violent without any regard for public safety. I will explain to you how he nearly created a fatal car collision involving six cars with my wife and I. It's now clear he's not going to stop at just me anymore. It's my intention to finally stop this vindictive revenge and to send this to the authorities for prosecution. He's ruthless, cunning, relentless, paranoid, egotistic, and corrupted. I know this man because I have been his number one victim for the last 23 years. Probably the only one he hasn't broke, and I will not submit to his ego. He manipulates everyone with fear and influence for control of the local authority. When I got tired of watching my complaints go unheard and the political corruption escalates, I decided to report to higher authorities. But soon after, I discovered the most disgusting criminal activities. Just as most people, I swore the oath to protect our laws, foreign and domestic, four times within my career. Honored that oath each time. I hold it dear above myself and will never let the people of our country down. Congressman Richard Pombo has taken that same oath. It clearly means nothing to him. In the upcoming episodes, I will display video recordings from a hidden camera. These videos are legal. The district attorney tried to cover up these videos with false charges. The video will clearly show acts of felony extortion, conspiracy, implicating the county board of supervisors that made these illegal decisions. I will also show reason that I had a major part in ousting Congressman Richard Pombo from office, only to never allow him to serve in office again. He tried in another district, but with his corrupt reputation, he did not have a chance. However, that was about 12 years ago. Since then, he has increased his destructive, corrupt activities with networks of people in each department he acquired while in office. His propensity for blackmail and corruption with his associates, it keeps him in the shadows of Northern California's justice and political system. If you are now intrigued, don't miss the rest of this video. It will impress you, but at the same time, it will disgust. You'll be disgusted of the involvement and witnesses that my evidence exposes. After 23 years and a lot of time on my hands, I have discovered how he operates and names the people who were directly involved with former congressmen. Through the years, I became Richard Pombo's obsession because of my insistence to achieve justice. He is very frustrated because I am an honest man that has nothing to hide. To him, he doesn't believe no one can be that honest. He keeps trying to destroy my life and my company. He uses civil servants with a badge to spread his hate. Many times I would seal a business deal, and soon I get back to my office to write the papers, I get a call from that customer to cancel the contract. One time I called a friend that works down the street to look in front of that business, and he saw a cop just leaving. At that time, I made a promise to myself, no one should ever have to live in fear and be terrorized just from making an honest living. That itself makes me more determined than ever. The man who surely thinks he will never get caught. I had privately investigated his activities for several years, but who could I report these evidence to? I tried several times, half of the authorities in fear of him, the other half was in on it or didn't care. I will soon tell you how he operates and several of his secrets, and most of all, how he defies justice for many years. Some names will be withheld only from the public, so the guilty will not know their names. That way the guilty can have a chance to come forward and turn themselves in. Just remember, the first confession always gets the best deal. This nightmare started in November of 1993. I was working at the Defense Depot in Tracy, California for 16 years of civil service, including 3 years in the United States Army. A warehouse accident kept me in on light duty for a while. During that time, I was also a shop steward. No one ever told me that it involves dirty politics within the civil service. The lies, conspiracy, and corruption were all around me. I wrote a book in 2008 titled Color of Authority. This book will show you my personal experience, moments of intimidation, threats, and potential violence influenced by hate, organized by management, namely William Arnolfo, within the workplace. The book continues beyond after I left the department. I will refer to portions of the book. Some parts are relevant to this story at hand. For several years, I have owned a business in Manteca, started in 1988. It supplemented my income for my family's future, increase of 2 kids. Every chance, Richard Pombo had interrupted my business with his corruption since I have left the department in 97. Several times he would spread hate with his connections of civil service employees who deter my customers from my business. After I would only accept phone calls, I do business from out of town customers because I didn't want anyone getting hurt. At more times, a car would drive and cut me off, even try to run me and my wife off the road. In episode 2, I will discuss how he stalks my every move to strike every chance he gets. Nearly 5 car head-on and fatal collision with less than 5 feet clearance caused by his associates just to try to run me and my wife off the road, and nearly got himself killed with more than 7 innocent people.